lady mentioned before, I am from Orlando, Florida. And there's a club out there I really love to play when I get home. It's a place called Rosie O'Grady's Good Time Emporium. It's a place called Church Street Station. Now, when I'm there, they call me the Church Street Song and Dance Man. The reason why is because I wear a lot of outfits, well, kind of like this. And I do a whole bunch of songs kind of like this.
Oh my honey, let me take you to Alexander's grandstand.
Personal favorites. It's a song, it's not done a lot anymore. Why, I really don't know. I think it's one of the prettiest, not one of the most moving, one of the most emotional songs ever written. It's from a show called Show. The tune is called Old Man River.
Trying how to live it.
I'm as helpless as a kitten up a tree. You know, I have been doing this song this way as long as I can possibly remember. Not that there's anything wrong with it, mind you, it's very pretty this way. But every now and then, I like to do things a little differently. Sometimes I like to do this song more like this. Look at me.
I was helpless as a kitten up a tree. And you know that I'm walking on a cloud, but I can't understand. I get missed here, just holding your hand. Walk my way. And the bells and violins begin to play. That will be the sound of your hello. The music I hear, I get missed here. The moment you're there. You can say that you're leaving me out, but that's just what I want you to do. But you know that I'm helplessly lost. That's why I'm following you. Say that you're leaving me on, but that's just what I want you to do. But if you never ever see it on, that's why I'm following you. I'm following you. But I want you to do this wonderland, Lord. And you know I'm not even from my eyes, my hands, my glove. I get misty.
I mentioned I was from Florida. Can I have that mic stand back there for a second?
Yeah.
Thanks, Haiti. Like I mentioned before, I'm from Orlando, Florida. Now, I suppose California's following the same pattern, but one of my favorite things to do when I go back home is go to the beach. Unfortunately, when I go to the beach, people usually wonder what I am going to do at the beach. What I like to do is something called playing with people's heads. Now, for those of you who don't know what that means, and there may be one or two of you, that means doing something that you don't normally plan to see done. For example, last time I was home, I was running around Daytona Beach for a little bit, just kind of minding my own business, you know, having a little fun. And I wandered into a drugstore, wandered up and down the aisles. You know, sometimes you do that, you know, just really not looking for anything, just kind of wandering. And I saw something I could have some fun with. So I reached down and I picked up the biggest, the largest bottle of suntan oil I could find. Yeah, 10 grade stuff. Yeah. And I walked over and I set that bottle on the counter and the guy looked at me like I was crazy. He said the obvious question, what are you going to do with the suntan oil? I said, look, if you really want to find out, follow me down to the beach and I'll show you. This guy was so curious. He was so curious to find out, he followed me. He followed me to the beach. He closed up his store, locked it up tight as a drum, followed me to the beach. So here I am. I'm walking to the beach. I got my towel over my shoulder, my basket in my hand, my bottle of suntan oil, and this jerk following behind me. I walked this guy for a mile and a half, just to see if he'd go. He did. So I stopped. I put the towel down, spread it out so there was no lumps in it, sat down on the towel, put the basket down, picked up the bottle of suntan oil, took the cap off of it, and did this. Oh. I made this guy's life. He's going to be talking about this for Christmases to come, I can almost guarantee it. But anyway, going on here, let's see. I've touched about every kind of music here. I want you to use your imaginations now for just a moment. I'd like you to imagine that you are no longer on the Delta Queen. I want you to imagine, ladies and gentlemen, that you are now at a train station. Your bags are packed. Your ticket is in your hand. The porter is yelling, "All aboard!" Cute. And imagine the name of that train is the Chattanooga Choo Choo. Yeah! Chattanooga Choo Choo, Track 29. Boy, you can give me a shine. I can't afford to call the Chattanooga Choo Choo. I got my fare and just a trifle to spare. You reach the best train station about a quarter four. Read a magazine and you're in the hall. Nothing can be finer than to have your hand in Carolina. When you hear the whistle of an 8-5, then you know Tennessee's not really far. Shovel all the coal and gotta keep it rolling. Ooh, Chattanooga, there you are. There's gonna be a certain party at the station. Sad and lazy, face that cow funny face. Well, she's gonna cry until I tell her that I'll never go.
To Miami Beach on a Hollywood.
but I'm taking her grave on the Hudson River line. I'm in a New York state of mind. Seen all of those movie stars and their fancy cars and the limousines. I've been high on the Rockies, up on the Evergreen. But I know what I mean, and I don't want to waste no time. I'm in a New York state of mind. It was so easy living day by day. I don't care if it's in Chinatown or up on the riverside. I don't have any reasons. I've left them all behind. I'm in a New York state of mind. I don't have any reasons, 'cause I left them all behind. Experience with music was in the church. It's where it started. That's where the first time I ever heard music, first time I really ever experienced it. Now, you have to understand something about black churches. They're a little different. First of all, you get up, you get dressed in your Sunday best, Not quite this best. But you get up and you get ready to get to church somewhere around 9:30 and you plan on staying till 1. You know, you pack a lunch. That's the way it works around here. And it's okay, man, because you can hear the music starting about a block before you actually get to the church. You see, when you walk in the door, you see a choir of about, 30 or 40 people in maroon robes with gold around them. And black choirs only have one level, loud. And there were no microphones back then. There wasn't. Everybody was just up there doing it. And it was a sound to it. It was a wonderful, glorious sound. It was a good feeling, too, as you walked in the church. It sounded something like this. Help me out, guys.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Give me another one.